And sorry, well, my name is Tamlin Gilbert. I'm a resident of Northland and I'm also a board member. I must apologise for flogging a dead horse, but I have a question that I think is pertinent and slightly more specific to the point. I'll just go ahead. The CMHE was instrumental in bringing the situation in Northland to a head. Under the National Housing Act, the CMHC has a responsibility to promote the improvement of housing and living conditions. Given that the CMHC has devolved all its financial programming to the NWT Housing Corporation, what role do you see this body having in bringing about a solution to the current problems in Northlands? I'd like to send that. I'd like to ask Great Slave and Cam Lake, if you'd like to come forward on that, please.
All right. So beginning with Glenn Abernethy of Great Slave Lake.
Thanks. Similar to the other individuals sitting at the table, I mean, clearly the GNWT must be involved in some capacity. We do have the Housing Corp. They do receive a significant amount of money from the CMHC. But it's not the GNWT's problem to solve. It's all the stakeholders' problem to solve. The GNWT must be involved. The owners of the 258 units in Northlands must all come together with a common idea and a common vision. They must be involved as one, and the City of Yellowknife must be involved. I don't know what percentage, if any, the GNWT should be putting in, but those are discussions that need to be had. And I like the suggestion that was made earlier about bringing the individuals who are suffering, who are, you know, living in Northlands with this hanging over their heads. We need to get them to the table, and we need to get the city to the table, and we need to get MACA, probably the Housing Corp, to the table. And I'm committed to working with my colleagues to make sure that whichever minister is responsible for those files is involved.
All right, thank you. Patrick Scott of Great Slave Lake.
Very brief answer. The Housing Corporation and the GNWT, of course, need to be involved. The level of their involvement needs to be clarified. The City of Yellowknife needs to move forward along with the corporation. It has gone on too long, and frankly, we're all tired about hearing about it. Every one of us. We don't live in Northlands, but we're tired of it. And you must be 10 times more tired than we are. Let's get it done. And let's get some timelines on it instead of still talking and talking and talking and say we need to do something. Let's put a calendar on the table and say by this date, we're going to start moving on reconstruction, and then figure out where the money's going to come from. Let's set some deadlines.
All right, thank you. I'm sorry, I apologize. I missed the second writing you asked for.
Cam Lake.
Go ahead, Dave Ramsey.
Thank you, and thanks very much for the question, Mr. Gilbert. I agree with Mr. Scott and some of the others. We need to put deadlines on this. I think it's ridiculous that, you know, this sat on a minister's desk in Ottawa for 15 months. Meanwhile, some of us were here asking questions of the government, saying, listen, the government of the Northwest Territories has to bear some responsibility, because you know what? It might not be our problem right now, but if there's a catastrophic line break that takes place in that trailer park, it's going to be our problem in a big way, because what? We're going to have 1,000 people out on the street needing a place to stay. We've got close to 500 children in there. There's elderly people in there. There's people with disabilities in there. And it's going to be a huge human tragedy. And it's going to be our problem. So we had better get on with it. And, you know, hopefully everybody can get to the table. There'll be a solution found. And the government of the Northwest Territory should play a role in that, and a very big role in that, before it becomes really our problem. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. And Brian Sutherland of Camway.
Thank you for your informative question. I say that because I wasn't aware that the HMC had this
CMHC
has this responsibility for safe housing, etc. I wasn't aware that they had passed that responsibility on to NWT Housing. So I think what I would like to do is determine what that amount it is, how much has been spent on what, and see whether or not, in fact, you meet the criteria with the National Housing, the NWT, or pardon me, the Canadian Housing Corporation, to which you refer. So I would like to look into that. If I understand your question correctly, there may be some a lot of merit to what you're saying, and there may be money there already.
All right, thank you to all our candidates and to our questions.